So now, with regards to my conception of truth and whether it's postmodern, it's like, no, actually, it's not. So, and it's a very complicated thing to sort out, because there is more than one way of conceptualizing truth. There's truth as it's manifested in ethics, and there's truth as it's manifested in the description, let's say, of the objective material world, and how those two things touch is not something we've sorted out well. In the ethical world, what's happened is that an ethic has evolved over time, I would say, and that ethic is reflected in the central axioms of civilized human behavior, but you can also see deep echoes of it in animal behavior. And it seems to arise out of the fact that the interactions that take place among paired entities that have to interact repeatedly across time follow a set pattern. So one of the things that Jacques Panksepp discovered, for example, was that if you paired rats together to engage in rough and tumble play bouts, which you might not think is particularly relevant, but actually happens to be dead relevant because that's a special circuitry and it's part of the circuitry upon which human ethics are based. If you pair them together first and one rat is bigger than the other, then the big rat wins. And so you think, well, play is dominated by power and that's how it works in rats and it's a power issue. But if you pair them together repeatedly, which is a much more naturalistic experiment, what you find is that once the large rat dominates the small rat has to ask the large rat to play. And if the large rat doesn't let the small rat win 30% of the time in repeated play bouts, then the small rat won't play anymore. And you think, well, so what? It's like, no, not so what. That's a major discovery. That's like Nobel Prize winning material. Because what Panksepp demonstrated there was that there's an ethic of fair play emerges even among rats. All you have to do is pair them together. And there are rules that govern iterated ethical interactions that are emergent properties. And those emergent properties are manifested, as far as I can tell, described in the great mythological stories that we tell, in the great narratives that underlie our culture. And they're not based on arbitrary assumptions. They're based on observations of what furthered survival and reproduction, to speak in a purely Darwinian manner, over massive spans of time. And so, and to point to truth as construed in a Darwinian realm, and to use the example of, say, iterated games to buttress that point, is by no means similar in any way to participating in the same process that the deconstructionists participate in. So I would say, well, on the side of the postmodernists, but not only the postmodernists, there are an indefinite number of ways of construing the world. That's been demonstrated technically. I don't think there's any debate about that. But there's a very constrained number of ways that you can operate successfully in the world. A very constrained number of ways. And it's not one way precisely, because it has its scope of variation, say, across culture and across environments, but it's very tightly constrained. Now, what's happened across the course of recorded history, let's say, is that ethic, this is something Nietzsche observed when he was critiquing the history of Western philosophy, is that ethic manifested itself first at the level of behavior. We act it out. We don't understand it. Just like a chimpanzee troop acts out the ethic of their hierarchy. They can't represent it. They can't articulate it. The structure emerges. The structure and the behaviors that are associated with the structure emerge before that is represented, and certainly before it's articulated. So first of all, the ethic that governs repeated interactions at different scales of social interaction, the structure emerges first, and then it's mapped, and it's first mapped in image and story, and then it's articulated. And I would say, well, I talked earlier about the role that England has played, that the UK has played in articulating the political doctrine of the sovereign individual. But the idea of the sovereign individual is far older than those political articulations. And it's based in a narrative structure that is in turn based on the observation of behavioral patterns that have emerged reliably across time. And so, and that's not postmodern in the least. It's a very straightforward claim that there is something that approximates a universal human ethic that's built deeply into our biological and social structures, and that was constructed in no small part as a consequence of Darwinian mechanisms. So.